chapter is deciding convergence or divergence. And we've already seen how we can do it for certain series, right? Harmonic and geometric. But not all the series will be either harmonic or geometric, so we need more tests, okay? Now, there is this theorem that we will use to decide convergence or divergence of a given series. So if I have a series A sub n, if we know that the series is convergent, okay, according to the theorem, then we can conclude that the limit of the nth term has to be zero, okay? Let's just take a look at the proof of this. It's very short, okay? How do you get A sub n? If you subtract S sub n, what is S sub n? It's A1 all the way to AN, right? Take away what? Which sum?
N minus S sub n minus 1.
S sub n minus 1. Do you guys see that? Right? So you have this, correct? Okay? So A sub n is the difference of S sub n, the nth partial sum, the minus the n minus first partial sum, okay? What do we want to do? We want to get the limit as n becomes large of a sub n, right? So that's going to be the limit of the right side, correct? Now the limit of the right side is, I can write as limit of s sub n as n goes to infinity minus, isn't it? I can do subtraction, right? Okay? Now because the series is convergent, that means to say we can talk of a number, which we called what? The sum, right? Okay. Now, the limit of S sub n as n becomes large is actually that sum, right? Correct? Which we called what?
S.
Likewise, I mean, this is arbitrary n, right? So the limit of S sub n minus 1 as n approaches infinity is also S, right? We don't know where n is, okay? So the limit is S, S minus S is
zero.
Okay? Remember logic, right? What did the theorem say? The theorem says what? Series A sub n is C implies, if we use the implication, what? A sub n goes to zero, okay? Common mistake of students is when they see this a sub n goes to zero, they will conclude that what? The series is convergent. Did you understand this warning? All the theorem said is if you know that it is convergent, you know that the nth term goes to zero, okay? But if you know that the nth term goes to zero, does that tell us anything? Actually, we've met an example like this where the nth term goes to zero and the series actually does not converge. Ivan said 1 over n. So for example, you have the harmonic series, right? Correct? This is the harmonic series. This is a divergent series, right? But if you get the limit of 1 over n as n goes to infinity, what's the answer?
Zero.
Okay? So if on your test you said, well, the limit is zero, of the nth term is zero, you cannot conclude that it is converging. Did you understand that, guys? Okay? So, but it's not that the theorem is useless, right? Okay? Why did we state the theorem? Well, because, okay, and let me erase the board. What do you think is the use of that theorem? P implies Q, what else is true?
Because if it's not equal to zero, we die, right?
Very good. Did you hear what I said? P implies Q, what else is true? Not Q implies
P.
Not P. Did you guys do logic?
Yeah.
It's like philosophy.
Right.
That's like philosophy class.
So let me put it here. So this is P implies Q, right? This is true, correct? So we can take the, what do you call that? It's the contrapositive, right?
Oh my God.
The contrapositive is true, correct? So what's the contrapositive of this statement?
If
A of n is not convergent, the limit of A of n is not zero.
If the limit of a of n is not zero, then the series is divergent.
Very good. Okay. Really, that's the next test for convergence that we have. All right? Say that again. So limit a n as n goes to infinity is not zero, right? Then you can be definite for sure, right? Without any doubt. I know that what? That divergence. This is what? This diverges. You guys convinced, right? Okay. If you know it's convergent, all you know is that the limit of the nth term is zero. If you know that the limit of the nth term is zero, you don't know anything. You understand?
You don't know anything.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
You don't know. We need more tests. That's why chapter 11 is long. Right? Okay? But if you know that the limit is of the nth term is not zero, then you're done. You can safely conclude that what? It diverges. So let's just look at a little example here. Yes.
So if the limit equals zero, it could be convergent or
divergent.
But if it's not zero, then it can only be divergent.
Divergent. Okay. Did you understand that? All right.
Wow.
So we are not happy with the zero answer for the nth term because that means to say we have to work some more. Okay, and that's why we're only in 11.2. That's why there are a lot of sections. Question, Kevin.
This theorem only applies when you're using an nth term test?
It's the nth term test. So that's what, like on your test, you quickly look at your nth term, right? If I give something like this, 1 over n times n plus 1, right? We already know this guy, right? If you quickly look at this, hopefully you can eyeball it and you say what? Well, you see that it goes to zero, but you cannot say it converges. Well, what does it? You cannot say it converges. Although in this case you're lucky, right? Why are you lucky? It's a telescoping series that we already learned, right? Okay, but your reasoning is wrong, correct? Okay. So, but fortunately you're happy, but for the wrong reason. Okay. Did you understand that, guys? Okay. On the other hand, if I have something like this, we haven't met this yet, right? Okay, 1 over n squared plus 1, okay? You quickly eyeball the nth term. So the nth term, you notice I'm just looking at this, right? Without the series notation, okay, the summation notation. Hopefully you can eyeball this quickly and say, well, it goes to 0, right? Okay? So this goes to zero, but can you conclude anything?
No.
No.
Yeah, so you need to work more, okay? Did I confuse you by putting a C here? This is C, but not because, right?
Definitely.
Do you understand that?
It's C because of the telescope, not because of
it's
that.
It's C, not because the nth term went to zero, but because we already examined it before and it is telescoping. And we found the sum, right? Okay? Now, so here we haven't met this guy before, and I was hoping we can meet him today. But okay, so we have this, right? You eyeballed it and you saw it's zero, right? But it doesn't really do anything to you, correct? You have to say, well, I don't know. I need to work harder and investigate this. Do you understand? Is that clear?
Yes. Yeah.